9 o'clock, we'll have our Spanish service, followed by Sunday school, worship service at 10:50. There's an SBRC committee meeting at 10:30, and Easter, children's Easter program, which is an encore of the Easter party program that was presented to our community. Confirmation class at 4, UMYF at 5, that's Sunday. Here's our classes. Finance Committee at 1:30, Girl Scouts at 5:30 on Monday. Tuesday, Food Pantry, Altar Guild. Wednesday, ESL class again, Bible Study at 5:30. Disciples Choir at 6:30, Handbell Choir at 6:30, 7 o'clock. The Spanish Bible Study, followed by Chancel Choir at 7:30. Thursday, Food Pantry, and UMYF Day Circle, UMW Night Circle, and Western Hills Neighborhood Association meets at 6:30 here on Thursday. We are praising again next Saturday at 6 o'clock. That's it.
Both the SBRC and the show
at the same time. Oh, yeah. The SBRC is more of a formality, so there's really not a meeting other than a scheduled meeting.
Thank you. Wipe away every stain. I'm not who I used to be. Oh God, I'm not who I used to be.
start with joys and concerns. We continue to pray for Jamie Goodwin, who was released from the hospital and sent home to recuperate. We will pray for Faye Nettleton, who had surgery on her hand. According to her daughter, was crushed. The surgery was done on Tuesday. And then we have Penny Conferini, who is, as I understand, at Renaissance Medical Center. So we'll continue to pray for her. Any others from the community? I'm thankful for your prayers. I'm thankful for this community. I'm thankful for Terry and for Loretta, who basically run the church in a very capable and very caring way. And I'm thankful for the opportunity to be able to go and be with my brother. He's doing much better. When there was a time there where we felt that he was going to die. And then, as I spent a whole week, Monday through Friday, in South Texas, he became alert on Friday when I came. But he is going to be out of the ICU on Monday. So that is pointing in the right direction. Any other? Baxton, we're glad to have you. We know that you graduated from Arlington Heights High School. And you're now at Texas Tech. Thanks be to God. They did pretty good in basketball, did they not? Yes, they did. But we're glad to have you. Any opportunity to see you while you're at school is a plus and a point of grace. Great to have you.
Keep my mother in your prayers. She's still, they have not had her walking yet. She stood up for 2 days, a little bit. There's still no walking yet.
Wow. So. For Alan's mother, we have been keeping tabs as to the progress going to the rehab center. And we pray that she is cared for, that she gets strengthened, and that she gets better. For these that we have mentioned, O Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Any others?
My brother actually came in on Tuesday, brought all his stuff. Back with the
wife
and the baby, so they are officially in
the forum. Well, that's great. Evan and Amanda and the little baby is Ezekiel. We're glad to know that they have made the move before birth. And I would pray that the Lord provides a job opportunity for Evan. He is a dental hygienist, and so we pray that he finds work and that they are able to establish their home for the families.
She's keep Sandy Allison.
Oh, precious. How's she doing?
She's doing great.
She's had quite a journey as we have prayed for her. We saw her get up from a scooter and be able to walk from here to there, and then an incident occurred where she fell, and so she has had a relapse of having to start again to get back on her feet. For Sammy Alice, Lord, in thy mercy, let us pray. Most gracious and loving God, there are so many reasons to be thankful today. We're thankful for this day, for each day that you give us is a gift. We're thankful for the life that we enjoy, even under circumstances of illness or circumstances of facing personal issues in our lives. We're thankful for this day, and we're thankful for life. We're thankful for this community of faith at Western Hills United Methodist Church. We're thankful that there are many families who strive to sustain it and support it as a light in the community, a light that shines for Jesus Christ, and a light, O God, that does things that are caring and loving in expressing your love.
thankful, oh God. We're thankful for Terry and for the leadership that he provides here at the church. We're thankful, oh God, for our children, those that are part of a church and those that are part of the community. Help us to explore ways of continuing to connect with a community that is in need of Christ, a community that is in need of witness, a community that is in need to be helped. Dear God, the psalmist put it so beautifully, I will lift my eyes into the hills. From where does my help come? My help comes from God who made heaven and earth. For that affirmation, for that assurance that we have in you, we are thankful. Thankful to have Paxton back with us. And as she goes back to school, continue to direct her and continue to sustain her in her studies so that the goals that she has placed for her life can come about. Be with each family represented here tonight, for Alan, his mother, for April, and her brother, Evan, his wife, Amanda, and Ezekiel. For Amy Solomon, who does so many things that contribute to the life and the witness of this church. For Betty Jo Robinson, who tirelessly is present every time that one of our members is in the hospital, or every time that someone needs care, Betty Jo is always ready to respond. For Terry, oh God, for the call that you have placed in his life, for the wonderful expression of how he embraces ministry here at Western Hills, we're thankful. And yes, oh God, we're thankful for the Shaws, for Chester, for Tina, for Tristan, for Paxton, for Ashton. Ashton, who at this time is going through confirmation. We pray that you help his pastor be able to lead this confirmation class to the point where our children who will be confirmed know in whom they have believed. We pray these things in the precious name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And word for the Fries. Anytime that they're not here, they're either babysitting or they're sick or they're out of town. One of those three.
There's a lot of things.
The scripture that I'll use tonight comes from 1 John, the first chapter, verses 1 through 10, and then chapter 2, verses 1 through 2. Hear these words. We declare to you who was from the beginning, what we have heard, what we have seen with our eyes, what we have looked and touched with our hands concerning the word of life. This life was revealed, and we have seen it and testified to it, and declared to you the eternal life that was with the Father and was revealed to us. We declare to you what we have seen and heard, so that you may also have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father, and with his Son, Jesus Christ. We are writing these things so that our joy may be complete. This is the message we have heard from him and proclaim to you, that God is light, and in him there is no darkness at all. If we say we have fellowship with him while we are walking in darkness, we lie and we do what is and we rely and do not do what is true. But if we walk in the light, as he himself is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. If we say that we have no sins, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess with our sins, he who is faithful and just will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. Then two verses from chapter 2. My little children, I'm writing these things to you so that you may not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. And he is the atoning sacrifice for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. And the Lord bless the reading of Holy Scripture. Amen. There's five young people who are in the confirmation class. And Ashton is one of those. And when we came together, basically I said, the theme of what we're doing is credo. It's a Latin word which means creed, which also means to believe. What is it that we believe as people of faith? And so John puts it forth to us, almost to say, in light of the resurrection, in light of what God in Christ Jesus has done for us, he has forgiven us of our sins. This then should be our witness to others, that God in Christ Jesus has come to us as the Son to reveal the love of God the Father, and to reveal that theme that also runs through the Gospels, that in God, in Christ Jesus, there is eternal life, and that there is communion with God through the forgiving of our sins. It is an atonement that only Jesus Christ could have achieved, and it reveals to us the love of God. When I was in single young adults growing up, I mean, I would have graduated from high school, and I was in the same age level as Paxton. I was probably 19, 20 years old. And in South Texas, there was a strong group called Single Young Adults among the United Methodist Churches. And so we were planning this big convocation of single young adults in the district. And at FAR, that's the town, we had this almost like a revival service. The only thing is that I was supposed to speak about sex, of all things. For young people, sex is a interesting subject. And so I was to speak about sex. And I said, what can I say about sex? Well, I approached it in a moral way, that sex was a gift of God, and that this was made for and given to us for our enjoyment. But there are certain ways in which it's appropriate, and certain ways in which it's not appropriate. And listen to this. I tried to put it like a sermon, where I almost had an altar call at the end. In fact, I did have an altar call. And the altar call was this. I know many of you have had illegal sex, unwanted sex. And I know that many of you, as me, have done it in the dark. It's time for us to come out of the darkness and come and be forgiven. How many people do you think stood up or had the nerve to stand up? Nobody! Nobody came to the altar. Nobody confessed that they had had sex that was inappropriate, out of marriage. Well, but what stayed in my mind, if anyone has sinned, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And so, it also speaks about sin. And as single young adults, sometimes growing up, we don't have a strong foundation of what is right and what is wrong. And it's important for us to go into Scripture, to come as a community of faith, and discuss the things that are wrong either with our lives, or the things that are wrong in our community, or the things that may be wrong in our nation that are immoral, and speak out that God forgives all sin. And that means that God gives us a second chance to start anew and live a life that is called a life in righteousness, a life in right relationship with God. And it uses an interesting way of comparing what is life that is righteous and life that is not righteous. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. Reminds me of Wesley's bands, classes, and societies. When the group met in smaller groups, they were called bands, and they had a leader. And the leader facilitated a time in which people declared things they were struggling with that separated them from God. In other words, sin. And in an honest and transparent and with integrity, they shared their souls with each other. Basically, they were sharing their souls to God. And the community, the small band, then became people who were a support group for those who honestly declared, hey, I struggle with sin. I struggle and I can't help myself from not being able to empower myself to draw distance. Help me. Can you imagine? If people said, I cheat on my taxes, I don't want to do that anymore, I need to pay that which is owed to Caesar, I cheat on my friends by not telling them the truth, to declare sin is a difficult. Yet, the community of John, that we call the Johannine community, were people who struggled for survival, struggled to know what was the truth, struggled to understand what it was to live a righteous life. And we go back to those that keep the text. If anyone has sinned, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, our Lord. In the power of His blood, Jesus as the Lamb of God, and the power of His blood will cleanse us from all sin. So ask him. If you want to see an example of how to speak about your faith, read the first chapter of 1 John and the two verses in the second chapter. And that is an example of how to declare one's faith in God. Creo. I believe. This is my credo. This is my personal statement of faith. And there's many in the scriptures, but this is one that stands out for us tonight. We all have sinned, Paul says, and we fall short of God's glory. The problem is that none of us are comfortable speaking about our sins. Quite an interesting story in relating with people. She says to me, "Now, you think that this person is very close to me. She's not. I can't say anything in front of her that she doesn't go around and tells it to others as gossip." Well, how many of us have the nerve to say, "I like to gossip"? When I gossip about others, it makes me feel real good. But it's wrong. It's wrong. And we dismiss it by saying, "Oh, it's a fight line. Oh, it's totally just entertainment to pass the time." But in passing the time and gossiping, we're hurting others. If anyone has sinned, and here I count myself as one of those, a sinner. And only by God's grace do I dare say that I reflect the light of God. Only through God's grace can I say I can do good toward others in the name of Jesus Christ. Only through Christ. Only through Christ can we be forgiven. Only through Christ can we have relationship with God. Only through Christ can we have worth living. It's worth striving for if we have an idea of what eternal life really means within the context of faith. To be eternally in relationship with our God in a way that is harmonious, in a way that is enjoyable, in a way that is pleasurable, in a way in which we experience rest and peace. Can we be honest about ourselves? Can we seek God through Christ Jesus our Lord? And can we accept the forgiveness that is ours from God through Christ Jesus our Lord, in the power of the Holy Spirit? Thanks be to God. Amen. Let me ask you, in the serving of communion at 10:50, we are using the Great Thanksgiving that are appropriate to the season. How many of you connect with the liturgy? Or how many of you connect when I don't use the liturgy and just, as we say the main components of it, and briefly of the Holy Communion? Do you like reading the liturgy? Is it meaningful? Because if it's not, we'll stop and we'll do it the way I do it on Saturday night. The service begins with an invitation. Christ, our Lord, invites all to earnestly repent of their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. I'm going to repeat it only because April's father has told me that I need to repeat certain things, and I can't quote. It is Christ our Lord who invites us. We do earnestly, earnestly repent of our sin, and we seek to live in peace with one another. On the night in which Jesus gave himself for us, he took bread, gave thanks, broke the bread, offered it to us, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And so, when the supper was over, Jesus took the cup, gave thanks, offered it to his disciples, saying, "Drink from this, all of you." Not just some, all of you. "This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. As often as you drink from this cup, do it in remembrance of me." And so now we bless the elements. Send forth, O God, your Holy Spirit, upon us gathered here, and upon these gifts of bread and cup. Make them be for us the body and the blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in unity with all, until Christ comes in final victory, and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Church, all power and glory are yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. And now, because we are children of God, let us join in the prayer that the Lord taught us to pray when together we say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen." I want to ask Terry to come. I will serve him, then he will serve me. Then we will invite everyone else to come. Let me serve. Terry, body of Christ.
Children from the outside, I work.
of thanksgiving is simple. We give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go in your spirit to love and serve others in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Benediction.
I'm just kidding.
May the Lord bless you and keep you.